How's it going, my people? This is your boy Wired Up, and welcome to another episode of Wired Up TV. Hope you guys got your hands on the steering wheel and keeping those eyes on the road. Keep your eyes on that road, guys. I don't know how many times I have to tell you guys how important that is to be there for your family, to be your own man, to bring in the money, to let your wife relax and be able to keep her health, to bear plenty of your kids, healthy kids, and be able to stay home and take care of them and be a woman. That's very important. A woman is not supposed to work as hard as men. That's just the way it goes. Not saying women can't handle it. It's just that's the men's job. With that being said, let's get down to the video, y'all. I know you guys can see it already. I put it right up for you guys. This picture of Tupac on the left, which I'm pretty sure you guys have seen before hundreds of times. So this picture of Tupac on the left is very, very popular, okay? I know you guys have seen it before hundreds of times. It's supposed to be Tupac walking around the MGM Casino in Vegas, September 7th, 1996, the day he allegedly got shot, okay? But look what the Wired Up TV family, team, subscribers, and fans have found out, okay? First of all, I want to give the biggest shout out to my homie, Joe Gracia from Lake Havasu, Arizona. Joe Gracia from Lake Havasu, Arizona. My homie and family, okay? Me and Joe Gracia collaborated, put our heads together. And with his big, big, big help, we figured out that this picture on the left that circled was fake. You guys gotta remember, Tupac hired a very professional team. This team was good not only for 96, it was good for 2000, 2006, 2007. They had the most advanced technology, the smartest people, okay? You guys have to remember, Tupac knew people in places, you know, we can only fathom. He's been to Italy, famous all around the world. There's people that would approach him, right? That we wouldn't believe, okay? Plus he had money and he had time. The Wired Up TV team has already proven to you guys. And this, you know, was said not by us. This was said by Muta, all right? By Napoleon from the Outlaws, his homie. All right, then months before September 7th, 96, Pac read them a letter from a woman that told him he has to leave death row now, ASAP. Something bad is going to happen to him. Tupac got in contact with this woman, ASAP, figured out what was going to happen. They talked, he figured out everything was real, everything was legit, and he started planning from then. Okay, we estimate he had about 3 months time to figure this out. Guys, I showed this picture to a couple of people, some I cannot mention, but I can tell you that Gloria Cox, Tupac's aunt, saw this picture and was shocked and amazed, okay? Shocked and amazed. I can't go into detail for what exactly she said because, you know what I'm saying, I got my word and I promised my contact I would just say what was allowed for me to say, okay? Where he's watching the way he moves. He's figuring out everything. He does not want to offend anybody. Does not want to put his name out there just yet. But guarantee he will. Okay? He will. The Wired Up TV team has been telling you Pac's alive for the longest. We've proved multiple time and time again. We've put out every source of evidence, whether y'all believed it, whether y'all didn't believe it, whether you guys had seen it before or didn't see it, we put everything out there so we can put the puzzle together from scratch. There's a difference. A lot of these things that you guys say, well, I've seen that before. Of course you've seen it before, okay? But what does that help? A lot of people have showed you this proof but had never done the due diligence, went out there, talked to people, and got an answer for it. Okay, a lot of people I found, oh look, there's Tupac behind, you know, wearing the green shirt behind Tupac, you know, gambling. All right, well, what are you gonna do about it? Go figure it out. Go ask questions. See what's going on. That's what separates Wired Up TV from the rest. That's why we're on international news. That's why we're on international papers. Okay, that's why we have never been attacked or spoken about in any negative way by any of Tupac's close friends, family members, and etc. Because we're the realest and we're gonna come at you. You guys need to join and hop on this movement. Wired Up TV is going to blow the world, guys. We got a lot more proof out here, okay? A lot more proof out here that we still have to put out. We have stuff that if I were to put out right now, it would even shock you guys even more. Look at this picture, guys. This is proof that this picture is fake. It was fake. It was Photoshop, professionally done by the best. Okay? By the best. It cannot get any more easier, guys. All right? The death certificate's completely off. All right? The supposedly last picture taken of Tupac is the wrong date. You know what I'm saying? It's from the next date. Okay, you got people, Suge Knight, Tretch, Mopreme Shakur, you know, have said in some interviews, Suge Knight Jr., that Tupac is alive. Okay, that's coming from his best homies, families, and friends, guys. All right, that's way before Wired Up TV even spoke about this. All right, I've spoken to a lot of these people, guys. A lot of them. And I've gotten so much information, so much intel with all this research, putting the pieces together, figuring out what's going on. Why doesn't this fit? Why does this fit? Why does this person say that? We need to go talk to them. All kinds of things, guys, to figure out what's going on and where Pac is. This picture right here is proof that September 7th, 1996 was fake. It was all faked. Pac faked it to escape jail and escape being murdered, and he shoved that stuff in the United States government and the whole world's face. He showed his enemies and his future murderers that they could kiss his behind, that they were not going to be successful in whatever they were trying to do. Only one person could pull out something like this, and that person is Tupac Shakur. I don't know why it amazes people that Tupac did this. There's been broker, less known, more wanted fugitive gangsters that have done this before and gotten away with it, guys. This isn't something only Tupac has ever done. Many people have done this. They've gotten away with it, guys. There's a gentleman that got away with it for over 24 years. All right? Over 24 years. All right? And he was wanted for murder, robberies, and all kinds of things. Do your research. Look it up. It is not illegal to fake your death. Okay? It is not illegal to fake your death. The only thing that would be illegal of faking your death would be stuff that came with it. Like if you got a fake social security, if you know you got money for your death in the insurance fraud and things like that. Tupac did none of these, okay? The only thing he would be wanted for is fleeing the country of his case, right? So a warrant. That's why he would never come back. Not because he's scared of jail or all that stuff, because he's in Cuba, where he knows the American government can't touch him even if they knew where he was, okay? The cops know Tupac's alive. They knew a couple of weeks after September 7th, a couple of weeks after he allegedly passed away, they knew this was BS. They figured it out. That's why nobody was never arrested. That's why they had Orlando Anderson right there and could never, ever arrest. Come on, guys. They would arrest him and just done something real quick to him. But they didn't, because he didn't do nothing. They knew what was the real. Now check out this picture right here, okay? This is another picture, right? Obviously this ain't Tupac, okay? Obviously this is somebody else, all right? These pictures were used for in a show. See how easy it is to reenact this and put this gentleman here. Look how perfectly he's matching with this picture right here. Perfectly he's matching to this picture right here. There is no flaws whatsoever. the same thing that Tupac Shakur did. This is proof, my people. I don't know how much more I can show you guys for you non-believers to get this. If you don't believe Tupac's alive in 2019, man, you lost. You know what I'm saying? If you still believe he passed away, knowing that 23 years and some change, like 24 years later, nobody's been arrested for this, and you still believe Tupac is dead, you need to wake the hell up, brother. Because you're on the wrong side. You're dreaming, okay? You believe too much in what the American news and the American government tells you. You're a puppet. You're being brainwashed, and you need to wake up. There's a lot of people that are asleep that claim this, that claim that, that claim this and this and this and that here on YouTube. All they're doing is talking. It's nothing but talk on YouTube. Don't let nobody brainwash y'all. Keep it real. Be your own man. Do your own research. Do your own due diligence. Do your own thing. If you got any information, send it to wiredupTV4you@gmail.com, and you can join the Wired Up TV team. You can remain anonymous or get credit. Don't matter. It's up to you. We will respect your decision 100%, guys. We need to wake up and smell the coffee, and we need to handle what we got to handle. Tupac is alive. He never died. He never got shot, okay? He was wearing a bulletproof vest on September 7th, 96. There's plenty of proof of that, okay? We showed you guys a picture on the last video where Tupac was wearing, I guess, a little overcoat and stuff like that. I asked for the Wired Up TV family to help me and find me more pictures of this moment. And it's from that exact day, September 7th, 1996. But he's wearing a coat, okay? These pictures have just started to come out. He's wearing a coat because he was wearing a bulletproof vest that night, okay? This is not something anybody's made up. This is something that the Tupac Alive community has been theorized for years, okay? This is not something we just made up. There's people that have said it, okay? Daz, his baby's mama, said this herself, that he was wearing a bulletproof vest that day, that night, okay? She said that herself. And we believe that picture with the coat is when he was wearing it. But that's another story for another time. I just want to show you guys that we're still doing research on everything we bring up on this show. We just don't bring it up and talk about it just to show you guys he's alive and then forget about it. We bring it up. We tell you guys about it. Ask for your guys' help if you guys can help us. Some of you guys come through. Some of you guys just want to watch. Some of you guys come through but want to remain anonymous. It don't matter. We're doing this as a team, and this channel is for y'all. I told you guys for years. So we proved to you guys, once again, that Pac is alive. That picture was a complete fugazi. It was fake. It was a fraud. They photoshopped it. Tupac had the best team back in 1996. Couldn't nobody figure it out, guys. He put the wool over the American government's face, over his enemies, and everybody. This picture was fake. Look, they're doing it now. They're showing you how easy it is. This picture is a fake. It is a fake. Tupac Shakur faked his death. All right. We just proved to you guys right here. Even Gloria Cox agreed with this picture. Guys, we're getting closer and closer. I'm getting this feeling that we're about to pop open a gasket, guys. Okay. Send any information to wiredupTV4you@gmail.com. wiredupTV4you@gmail.com. Any information you guys got. Okay, I got a feeling we're about to pop this case wide open, and I got a big feeling one day Pac is going to speak up and he's going to mention us. Let's keep on it, guys. We are the Spark Brain. Don't let nobody tell you different. Keep on researching. Keep on being yourself. Keep on being original, and keep on handling your business. Don't let go of that steering wheel, guys. Keep positive. And like I always tell you, my people, stay wired up. I'll talk to you guys very soon. Peace out.